Welkom allemaal. In het Nederlands heel hartelijk welkom aan jullie allemaal die hier aan het kijken zijn op dit moment. Mijn naam is Tim Kliphuis. Ik heet jullie hartelijk welkom bij Tivoli Vredenburg vanuit Cloud 9. Live op de contrabas, Sani van Mullum. Woehoe! Op ritmegitaar Johnny Rosenberg. En op solo-gitaar Moses Rosenberg. Wij spelen een programma dat alle kanten op gaat vandaag. And I would like to now move to English, if that's okay with you guys, because we have a lot of listeners, a lot of watchers, in countries like Switzerland, Germany. I had messages from the UK, from Norway, from France, from the US. Many people are sitting at their breakfast table right now. It's 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock there in the morning. Lots of people from all over the place, including even South Africa. So big, big welcome to you all. And if it's okay with the Dutchies, I'm going to continue in English. This tune was called Webster. It was a composition by Django Reinhardt, the guy who invented this style, gypsy jazz, in 1934 in Paris. We're going to continue with a slightly more modern composition called Got a Match, composed by Chick Corea. Wil jij hem? Oh, je speelt een intro. Thank you.
Dat was mooi. Ja.
Is dat jij Pontianijn?
Oké. Okay.
Is dat een mooi nummer?
Ja, dat vind ik wel een leuk nummer.
Zoeken.
Zoeken.
Komt op maar.
Thank you.
Mooi, Tim.
Mooi.
Ja, mooi jongens.
Hij wacht met de dag beter.
We like that.
Minor Blues.
That tune was called Poinciana. It was a composition by George Shearing, I think. My great hero on piano, if I'm not mistaken. You can look that up online while you're watching. Now we play a composition with a big feature for Sani on bass here. Blues en mineur, minor blues. Yeah.
Keep an eye on that guy.
Hey, he's crazy. All right.
Thank you.
Sani van Willem.
Oh ja.
Sani.
Nice.
Gaan wij doen?
Thank you.
item.
Top, jongens. Leuk.
I hear some virtual clapping. Thank you very much. Moses Rosenberg. There you go. So that was How High the Moon, composed by somebody and somebody else. Hamilton and something. Anyway, we're about to play a very unusual tune. And when we got together for this concert, the guys suggested this tune and I'd never heard it before. So actually yesterday I was up all night practicing. And I think we can just about do it. It's a tune written by Fried Manders. And it's actually got several influences. It's got French, it's got jazz, and it's got Catalan. So basically Spanish, dare I say it, even though the people in Catalonia would call themselves Catalans. So, okay, especially for those people in Paris and in Barcelona, we will play for you Musette Catalana.
Yes.
Mooi verhaal.
Ja, vind ik ook.
Bij elkaar.
Ja, vind ik ook.
Thank you.
That was Musette Catalana with Johnny Rosenberg.
Thanks, Tim.
Playing that Spanish-French groove.
Yeah, man.
Well done, I say.
To play that.
So, these guys don't stay in the tradition of... Oh, there's something going wrong there with the water. These guys don't stay in the tradition of Django. They actually keep moving on. And at the same time, they don't forget their roots, which are, of course, in jazz. And the next tune is a Ted Gruya composition. It's very beautiful, and we're actually going to play two tunes. One's called Flamingo, and the next one's called Night and Day by Cole Porter. Thank you. That was Night and Day by Cole Porter. I just wanted to ask these guys one question so that you can hear the answer. I always get this question. So it's a big question that people have when they watch Gypsy Jazz. How do you guys work together? How do you learn? Because I worked at a conservatoire learning music from paper, these kinds of things. And I have this sort of degree where I talk about music and I talk about bars and measures and notes and rubatos and all kinds of stuff. And the first time I was privileged in Holland to have around me this whole tradition of Sinti musicians who live in camps here in Holland. And my very first visit was basically, I saw a gypsy band play and I said, can I have lessons? And they said, no, we don't do lessons. And I said, why not? We don't teach. But how do you learn? Well, that's the question. So, maybe Moses, could you kind of suggest, and I'll translate. Kun je zeggen, hoe leren jullie het?
Ja, wij kennen eigenlijk geen noten lezen, dus wij doen alles...
They don't read notes.
Wij doen alles op het gehoor.
It's all ear stuff.
Johnny eet wel heel veel noten.
Johnny eats lots of notes.
Yes.
That's a Dutch translation that doesn't go very well.
Maar we spelen ze niet. Ja, we spelen ze wel, maar wij kennen geen noten lezen.
They play notes, but they don't have names for them.
Ja, dus...
And so how do you learn? Where do you find, where do you listen to learn this stuff?
Het is eigenlijk het horen naar muziek en proberen na te spelen.
Dus zetten jullie cd'tjes aan of heb je ook in je familie nog mensen die...
Veel. Stochelo Rosenberg, mijn broer, dat was natuurlijk een hele grote voorbeeld voor mij ook. En voor ons ook, voor onze trio natuurlijk.
Uiteraard.
So, what he's saying is you learn from family as well, because uncles, grandfathers... Ja. And in his case, big brothers play this music and it's all at a super high level. So Moses was just basically grew up in a professional environment.
So, andere broers, Joshua Rosenberg, die speelt weer een beetje de
Joshua,
Spaanse stijl.
Who's more as a Spanish guitarist. But it's all guitar, right?
Mijn andere broer die speelt bas gitaar.
Oh, there's a bass guitarist in the family as well. Yeah. Thank goodness, Sani's not alone. These guys, I asked them, I still don't understand, but they are all cousins, sometimes second cousins, sometimes first cousins. And all their uncles and grannies are married and all that. So they are literally all family. Even though Sani has a different last name, Van Mullum.
Yeah.
But they're still family. And there are so many links within the families. And there are also all kinds of links to the different camps. So there's the camp in Zeeland where Fappy Laffertin, who is my first guru and also an inspiration, I'm sure, for you. That's a cousin of his mother. Right, okay, here we go. And so, let's see. There's one more guy. Vaso.
That is mijn oom.
Is his direct uncle.
Dat was de broer van mijn moeder.
And hij heet Limberger van achteren, toch?
Grunholz,
sorry. Yeah. So there's the Limberger family, the Grunholz family, and Vaso Grunholz, a very, very big figure. Who played beautiful waltzes and inspired Fappy to start playing and inspired the whole Rosenberg clan. So, as you see, nothing to do with education in the traditional sort of paper sense. It's all ear stuff and it's much older than the way that I learned music. So, a real school for me to be with them. Thank you guys for being here and for making music. We're going to continue. And not only do they play music, they also make music. So, Moses wrote a tune and he's very modest. So, he just called it Mosology. It's his own name with ology. So it's his science, Moses' science, Mosology.
Here we go. Thank you.
beautiful song.
Thank you.
Well, big thanks to the Rosenbergs, because they actually also learned one of my tunes. This was called Samba for Paula. Here you go, Paula, that's for you. Well, and thank you for playing it so beautifully. Wow, I'm so glad this has been, this moment has been caught, it's been captured. So let's play a little something, and then we're going to have to move to the end. We're actually pretty close to the air. I could not believe it, but I'm getting in my earpiece here that it's nearly time. Time flies. So I think we should go for Festival 48. What do you guys think?
Okay.
And then we can maybe squeeze in a little encore, maybe. If you guys are okay with that.
Yes.
Unless we get kicked out here. So, before we go, I would like to have a big thank you to Vredenburg, Tivoli Vredenburg Concert Hall. We're in Cloud 9. Thank you to Guy for asking us to change this live concert in the lockdown to something that is actually still a concert for you guys. Thank you so much. And also, yes, Moses is showing the Double Scotch album, which is a new album the Rosenbergs have brought out. Google it, Double Scotch, just like the whiskey.
Yes.
Also, here's the lockdown album that I made. It's called The Five Elements. And it's a total different thing that I'm doing there with Gypsy Jazz, but you might want to give that a look. Just Google The Five Elements, my name, and you'll get to that as well. So, is there anything more to say? Johnny Rosenberg!
Thank you!
Sani van Mullum! Moses Rosenberg!
Tim Kliphuis!
Yes, yay, of course!
Thank you! Here we go, Festival 48, Festival 48, a composition by Django Reinhardt.
Beetje rustig. Doucement.
De rusta.
Thank you. If you liked this concert, you can still pass on the details to other people, because it's going to stay online for a little bit. So spread the news, send the link to other people, and have them have a look at this. And we're just going to play you one quick more tune, I think. I think we can get away with that. We're not being stared at. There's a thumbs up. Good.
2 minutes.
Well, it's a traditional, so I think the only thing we can do is play the song that's maybe the most famous song in gypsy jazz. It's called... Well, in Russia, it's called Ochichornia. In France, it's called Les Yeux Noirs. Schwarze Augen in Germany. Dark eyes. Yeah, here we go.